wood. And I'll tell you, if you want to go to the next slide for me, please. And good morning, everyone. My name is Mike Watkins. I'm with the Mission Impact Department here at the National Office, and I'm the staff advisor to the Voice of the Scout program. And with us, welcome today to the webinar, Voice of the Scout Dashboard. And we're happy that you joined us. We appreciate very much your time and your interest in this. With me today on the phone will be Patty Bowman. Patty is the Voice of the Scout Administrator. She is part of our Mission Impact team, and will be helping today with the technology and lots of the notes and trying to get us answers to questions, if there are questions through the webinar, and just managing all the technology side. Also with us today is Cammie Elquist-Lorraine. Cammie is the Communication and Training Specialist with M3 Planning. If you were part of the JCE webinars last fall, you'll remember Cammie as being a part of those, or maybe 2 years ago in the fall. Cammie was a part of those and developing the material and being online as part of the presentation. Cammie has developed all of the training materials that we're using as Voice to Scout system, and is a key partner, consulting partner in the project along with M3. So you will see on the top right-hand side of your screen, you will see a little green or yellow box, and then right below that, you'll see a notes section. As we go through the presentation today, if there are notes, things that were there, questions or things we're not clear about as we present, please feel free to send a note, and we'll pick those up, and then we'll try and answer those throughout the call. So, Pat, if we go to the next training outline, slide 3. So the purpose of the webinar today is really to help you understand as we launch surveys that will be going out today. People will begin to respond to those surveys, and, of course, you're interested in what they have to say. And so there will be hundreds and thousands of surveys potentially for your council, depending on your council size. And so we've built a new Voice of the Scout dashboard that will be providing you information as it comes in from your survey respondents. So the webinar today is to help you understand the different components of the Voice of the Scout program and how they're shown on the dashboard. Now, it's important to know that this is a different and a separate dashboard from the JTE dashboard. Now, they talk to each other, and there are some common links between them. But we're not talking about the JT dashboard. We're talking about a new Voice of the Scout dashboard. Now, if you're familiar with the Journey Excellence Council dashboard, you remember that there are 18 dials, and when you click on a dial, you go to another screen, you see drill-down information, detail information. And the Voice of the Scout dashboard will be very similar from the standpoint that you'll see a home screen with high-level information. And then as you drill down into each of our segments, 7 segments, you'll begin to see detailed information about each of those 7 segments. And then finally, we want to go back through and review with you some of the reports and the different reporting mechanisms that are available from the Voice of the Scout dashboard. We covered some of those last month in the webinar. We'll review those this month again, just to make sure you're very familiar with those different reports, and then show you how to turn those reports on, and you'll want to do that today, since the surveys have launched. Patty, if you'll just go to the next slide then. As we get into launching all these different surveys, or as you launch the VOS survey to folks, it's going to happen in over a several-week period, twice a year. And so the cycle that we're showing you here is the spring survey cycle. And you can see there that in March or April we'll be in our listening phase, and that is the surveys launch, the youth, the adults, the parents, the charter organizational rep, those groups of people respond to the survey. And then in April, when the Journey to Excellence dashboard updates on April the 8th, then on April the 9th, you'll actually be able to see information on the Voice of the Scout dial on the JT dashboard, as well as then you'll be able to see the information populated to the Voice of the Scout dashboard. So the listening phase is simply sending out the surveys, having people respond. we'll talk about experience recovery notices. If people respond and they give you a low response, which is on a scale of 0 to 10, if they select 0 to 6, folks have an opportunity to tell someone about their problem and request a contact, a phone call, or email to talk about that with someone in the council. And so that will be part of our listening phase as well. Then in April and May, as the dashboard comes live, you'll see the results on the Voice of the Scout dashboard. You'll see the needle moving on the JTE dashboard around email saturation and around the NPS 200 bonus points. All that will be showing up on the JTE dashboard. Excuse me. And then finally, as you get that information, learn from it. What are people saying? What are the things they like that they want the council to keep doing? What are the things that they're not as happy about that they would like the council to change? Then that will be an acting phase. That will be the third phase, and that will happen through June, July, and August. You'll have reports to help you. You'll have information from comments. You'll have information from that promoter score question. You'll have driver questions. All of that will be on the dashboard, readily available, so that you can then begin to change behavior, change the way business is done in your council or in a district, so that folks have a better experience in their scouting program. Okay, next slide, Patty. And Kenya, I think, I'm sorry, this is one more slide for me still. So what the dashboard is, it's relevant information. It's designed to give you a high level as well as drill down information on each of our segments. It's information from a net promoter score, from driver questions and from comments to give your councils and districts information that they can act on. So the dashboard, and we'll talk about this a little bit later, for the dashboard timing, council dashboard available in April. Right now the development schedule is that a district drill down will be available in June, and then unit level information sometime will be available on the dashboard before the end of the year if everything stays on schedule. The management tool helps us move to factual information. If you've been involved in scouting for a period of time, if you're a customer, you understand customer service. We have volunteers and scouts, and they have a customer experience as well. And we have anecdotal information about things that we think boys like and don't like about our program. And using this dashboard is actually, in fact, going to give us then factual information straight from the horse's mouth, if you will, about the things that they like and don't like about our program and the things then that we can change to make the experience better. And then finally, as I mentioned earlier, the Voice of the Scout dashboard does tie to the Journey to Excellence dashboard. And so you will be able to see the different 25, 50, and 200 point metrics there on the JTE dashboard being brought across from this Voice of the Scout dashboard. Next slide, please. So who can see the dashboard? That's a great question. And really the absolute simplest answer is anybody that can see the Journey to Excellence dashboard right now will be able to see the Voice of the Scout dashboard. And so for councils, council professionals, council volunteers, council level volunteers, committee chairs, board members, folks like that, district chairs, district commissioners, those folks will be able to see the council level data. On an area level, volunteers who are involved on area committees, involved with area work, they'll be able to see all the council information within their area. Regional volunteers will be able to see all the council information within their region, and then national and professional councils, volunteers and staff will have open access to all councils. So, again, quite simply put, anybody that can see the Journey to Excellence dashboard right now will be able to see the Voice of the Scout dashboard. Okay, next. So key dates we've talked about here, the dashboard, the Voice of the Scout dashboard will go live on April the 9th. That will be after the update of the March information of the JTE dashboard. Again, if everything stays on schedule, in June you'll be able to see district level information, district drill downs, and then by the end of the year we'll have unit level information. So we'll be able to look at the NPS score, the driver scores, all the comments at all three of these levels by the end of the year as the technology department builds that stuff out. Okay, next. How do we get to the dashboard for volunteers? You can see on the right there that volunteers will be able to see only the dashboard, none of the reports, but they will be able to see a dashboard on their My Scouting account, just like they see the Journey to Excellence dashboard now. On the left, you can see for professionals and council employees and council for council staff, they'll be able to go to My BSA homepage, and on the left there, you'll see a Voice of the Scout section. So we have the Journey to Excellence link. And right below that, the Voice of the Scout link to the dashboard, the Experience Recovery Report, which is the number of folks that have, in fact, scored the council from 0 to 6 and want to be contacted. You see that little red indented thing there? That's the number of folks at any moment in time who want to be contacted. And we'll show you later on as those folks are contacted, there's a check in a box that's made, and then that number will decrease. Back below that is the summary report and the invalid email report. Again, those reports we'll review with you coming up in the next section of the webinar. So the next slide, please. How do you turn on those reports? How do you get those links on your MyBSA homepage? Every council has a MyBSA administrator. How they know that is on their MyBSA homepage on the far right. There's the administration tab. And so the instructions are here. Go to the administration tab, access the home link, and then activate. There'll be a list of all the employees with those four different boxes that can be checked. And so immediately following this webinar, you're going to want to check with your Scout executive and find out just exactly who it is he wants to have see this different information, who he wants to see the different reports, and have access to the dashboard. And then have your BSA administrator turn those on. Now, again, remember that the Experience Recovery Report, even though you'll see these links, if you turn them on, you'll see the links. There's no information there until April 9th, except the Experience Recovery Report. And you'll see that little red link lighting up with this folks want to be contacted. You'll see that come live. And so it is on April 9th when the dashboard goes live. And you'll be able to see data in all these other invalid email reports and summary reports and those sorts of things. Okay, next. Candy, why don't you tell us about the technology required to view the dashboard?
Sure. So the technology is much like the JTE dashboard technology. So if you can see the JTE dashboard, you've already been there, that means that your technology is updated and you should be good to go for the Voice of the Scout dashboard. Just in case you haven't been to the JTE dashboard for any reason, you do need to have JavaScript enabled on your computer. Most browsers have this as a default, unless your security is really high set for your browser. So you'll need to make sure that JavaScript is enabled. And the help desk, the National Help Desk, is really good at helping with this element. They helped a lot of people with the JTE dashboard. They're very knowledgeable on how to do this if you can't. But usually it's right in the permissions or tools of your browser settings. The browsers, Internet Explorer 7.0, I don't know of a single website that's designed for any earlier version than this, so if you haven't done it, it's just good to do in general. Safari 5.0, Firefox 3.6, and Google Chrome, its native version, the version that it started with, is an A-grade browser. So if you have Google Chrome, any of those versions should be able to pick up the Voice of the Scout dashboard. It should also work on your mobile devices, so it's just like a JTE dashboard. It should be pretty easy for you all to get to, and if not, there's always the National Help Desk to help, you know, with any technical issues. So let's go ahead and continue on. Okay, this is the system in sort of three big steps. And they go with the cadence of what Mike was just talking about with the listening, learning, acting phase. This is how the system sort of strides in alignment with that. So first we're gathering the information. We're sending the surveys out. The thing that's automated with, in addition to the surveys being sent out from National, is that experience recovery invite. So if someone scores scouting low on their tendency to recommend scouting to others in that 0 to 6 range, we'll go ahead at this module in gathering the surveys. We'll automate that experience recovery invite to the respondent. They can fill it out, and then we capture it with the experience recovery tracker report that Mike referenced, and we'll get to that screen. So we send the surveys out. The experience recovery element is an option here. Once the survey is submitted, everything is communicated into the dashboard. And as Mike said, mid-April, we'll go ahead and turn it all on. And then after that point, as we do surveys in the fall and the spring and in subsequent years, the data will be updated in real time. So everything gets going over to the dashboard. You can view it. Part of what's programmed with the dashboard is a monthly report. So we have several screens that are part of the VOS dashboard. The monthly report puts it into a nice format that you can print out. So these are good reports for staff meetings, for board meetings. It's a good way to rope people in that don't have access to the dashboard that you want to talk about this stuff with. So we do have that capability. It will be compiled monthly. And then, so that would be part of the learning phase. And then we would get into the act phase, to where you're recognizing trends, you're identifying root causes, you're getting your suggested measures out to your districts and your units. It's really the communication, the solving and communication phase of the program. Part of the important communication task to keep in mind is to reach back out to members at least once a year, giving them validation. This is what we're hearing from you, and this is what we can do right now, and this is how we're going to do it. It's really important to bring a 360. You do a couple things. You help validate their opinion, and you help garner more interest in the program, and positive momentum starts going in this way. Without doing that, people just think it's another survey, and they wonder if anyone's even listening. So that's a really important component of responding and acting on the Voice of the Scout program. Next slide, please. Okay, so this is the step one of the system, the survey. As we've mentioned a couple times, the 0 to 6 realm, if we get scored on how likely it is for someone to get recommend scouting to others, and they score us at this lower spectrum, we really need to hear from them. That's why the invite goes out. You know, promoters are very important. The passively satisfied people, they're important too. But detractors are a really interesting group. They have the ability to give us a lot of good insight on stopping any kind of attrition of your membership that might be taking place. And also by engaging with these people, you help them take the conversation about scouting to you in a constructive way instead of externally, to where they can actually do brand damage. So it's a really important component of this program to prioritize the experience recovery notices. We've said it before, and we'll probably say it again because it is that important. So this is the step one, and it is the survey. Let's go ahead and get to the next. Okay, so as we've said, everything populates and gets loaded into the experience recovery tracker that's available on MyBSA, and you'll get the red text line to let you know if you have experience recoveries that need to be attended to. You'll get the verification of when the respondent gave the response. You'll get who they are as far as what kind of audience member. Are they Cub Scout parents? Are they youth-facing volunteer? You'll get verification of the district that they're in as well as the unit. The name, as they populate it in their invite, and to be able to contact them, they'll give you their preferred email address or phone number. A best time to contact, which is great if they fill that out for efficiency's sake on our end. You'll get a verification of the NPS score, the tendency to recommend. You'll see they actually scored us. And then by clicking on the comments, you'll get to the verbatim that they've offered. And looking at that before you reach out via email or phone number, it's really important to get the conversation going on the right foot and get some common understanding before you go ahead and outreach to this person. So another important element of this is if, like Mike said, if you check off the contacted box on the far left column, this is what populates that red line number in the MyBSA reports. So once you've went ahead and you can do everything that you can do to help with whatever issue is brought up, when it's finished, go ahead and check contacted. And for those issues that perhaps are out of your control at the council level, please email them to jte@scouting.org, CC your scout executive, and that way we're understanding on what's going on that we can help you with. So that's an important element as well. You can use a spreadsheet, track those requests that you've sent on to jte@scouting.org, and we'll go ahead and do the same on our end until we come to a good conclusion for this number. So if you look in the upper left-hand column, you can see that you can set day parameters, so you can go back historically. And if you know that there was, you know, something that happened 6 months ago, and for some reason you need to recontact that person about, you know, that particular issue, this will serve as an archival reference for you as well. Okay. This is the Balanced Back Report. We talked about it a lot during our last webinar, and it is, you know, one of the reports that you can turn on the MyBSA website. I won't spend a lot of time here. It is what it is. It's those emails that we get bounced back for as being undeliverable. So by looking at this, you know how valid your database is. So by acting upon it and making sure that you correct the emails in the system, it's just going to make your Voice of the Scout information that much more reliable. Not only that, it really helps you make sure that your database that you use to electronically communicate to your members is accurate. So a great win-win kind of report, and something that definitely, as before we get into the next survey cycle in the fall, you want to make sure that you've checked off all these these bounce back emails and make sure that they've been corrected as possible. Okay, so you click on the link on the My Scouting or excuse me, MyBSA. This is your home page that you land on. So let's talk about how to navigate around. You can see that we have drop-down boxes for region, area, and council. So really within three different choices, you could be at any council and in the United States with just minimal effort. So it's very efficient in that way. And as we get into the summer, you know, we'll add a box, drop-down box for districts. And then as we get towards the fall and the end of the year, as everything goes on track, we'll be able to do the same for units. So you can see how quickly you can be able to, you know, drill down into where you need to go by the way this navigation is set on that top bar. Now the menu options on the left-hand side, NPS All Segments, that is the home screen. That is this screen right here. You also have a year-to-date snapshot. If you were to click on any one of these tiles for Cub Scout parents, Boy Scout venture parents, chartered organizations, you would be taken to that audience's year-to-date snapshot. The same holds true for the tabs up at the top. So that's how you navigate into the different audiences, and when you do so from this screen, you'll land on the year-to-date snapshot screen. There's also a comparison screen that I think is going to be really helpful, particularly as we get into districts and units, and then a comments page, which is really good for quickly being able to review the verbatims, and we organize them in a way that makes sense from the Net Promoter Score approach of operational improvements. So we'll go over that in just a second. So let's go ahead and move on, and we'll look into what the home screen really looks like. If you can see those tiles, we've blown one up. It says Cub Scout Parents. And what you'll be able to do here is pretty much verify everything that you're getting scored on in JTE. You can see how your bronze, silver, and gold, where those numbers are coming from. You can crunch them right here. The nice thing about having it separated by different audiences is that you'll quickly be able to see where your email saturation is for your Cub Scout parents versus your Boy Scout parents versus your facing volunteers. So you can see that the total registrants in the system, that's everyone in ScoutNet. The available to survey is everyone that has accurate emails. And by accurate, I mean not valid. They are those emails that have an at sign and a .com. They're just architecturally correct. So that is the email saturation calculation right there. And then 500 total responses and the response rate, that's what Silver is based on. And then you go ahead and get verification for the NPS for that segment audience. Now, your overall NPS, you can go ahead and get it on subsequent screens, but if you wanted to figure it out quickly here, it's just all seven of these numbers divided by seven. It's a mean average, and that way you can quickly verify any NPS figure that you're seeing in any other area. It might be JT dashboard or subsequent screens. Everything should go ahead and calculate out by adding these up, divided by seven. That's your council NPS. So also there's a year drop-down. Every screen has an area that you can go historical on it, and that's where this one is. You can back up and see what's happened, see what kind of progress you've made with each audience, get a feel for trending, and get a feel for how your efforts are yielding results. So let's get to the next screen. So this has a lot of stuff on it. This is the year-to-date snapshot. So if you were to click on any one of those tiles or tabs for any audience from your home screen, you would land here for that audience. So if you look, we have the District Council Volunteers tab up in the upper section. That's red. That's the audience we're on. You can see year-to-date snapshot. We have the blue circle. That's the council NPS. And then you see the national NPS, so you understand where you are performing in relation to national. And then with the question graph, this would be the Net Promoter Score question, the tendency to recommend scouting to others for district council volunteers. And then you can see your score, for your NPS score for this audience, and the NPS score for this audience at the national level. So another comparison, just isolating the district council volunteers. You can also see the percentage of detractors, passively satisfied, and promoters. So this is a great thing to understand, especially as you tab through the different audiences. You'll be able to see which one has the most detractors, which one has the most promoters, which one even has the most passively satisfied, because by making an experience for the passively satisfied audience more fulfilling, those people move up into promoters, and remember that the net promoter score is the percentage of promoters minus the percentage of detractors. So by paying attention to the passively satisfied group and improving their experience, it's the most direct way to improve your NPS number. So you'll also get a rundown of the comments in each one of these NPS categories of detractors, passives, and promoters, and you can start to recognize trends to take action on. Also, you'll be able to see all the driver questions. Due to space, we could just show you the first one here, but you'll get the mean average of that question, and again, as that relates to the mean average at the national, you'll be able to see sort of the ratio of those that are positively agreeing with that are satisfied with that question, neutral about that question, or disagreeing about that question. So what's really good about these driving questions is that you know for council district volunteers on this example, where you are excelling the most in meeting their expectations based on how high the average is on these questions. So you can quickly see where you're excelling in terms of what the driver question is asking. And remember, those driver questions are all developed and they've all been statistically tied to drive the NPS. They are causal factors of your NPS score. So by looking into the questions and seeing more specifically on how you can operationally address an experience for each audience, the driver questions are a great place to go to be able to understand more how to improve the experience. For this example, it would be for the district council volunteers. So let's go ahead and get to the next screen. This is your comparison screen. So right now, with where we're at in development, it would be the top 10% of all councils for the NPS score for district council volunteers. Now, that's our example here, the red tab up there, district council volunteers. The national rank is based on the NPS score alone. That's the only metric that determines that national rank. And then you can see that we color code the top 10% by region. So I would think that, you know, in your mind's eye, that it's pretty exciting that as we move into districts and eventually units, how powerful this page is going to become. Right now, it's great insight, and I think that as we develop the dashboard further, it's going to be just a great guide for reaching out to those just high-performing districts and high-performing units and getting those best practices established. This will help you focus where the good things are, the bright spots. So that's your overall comparison screen. Let's get to the next screen, please. Okay, so this is the comment screen. So you saw in the different, examples of the dashboard how we have, you know, the areas where you can see comments. You can click to get comments. Well, all the comments are right here. You can set your date parameters. The question, it'll open up a drop-down menu once you click there on the NTS question and all of the drivers for whatever audience you have chosen up on the tabs above. So in this case, it would be Boy Scout, Venture, Parents, listing all the questions that are directed towards that audience. And remember, the questions do vary slightly for each audience. So you click your audience that you want to go ahead and look into with their open field comments. You would click on the question box, choose your question you want to isolate, and then you could go down and read all the open field comments associated with that question. So if you knew that one of your driver questions based on the prior screen was scoring low, you could go to this page, select that specific driver question, and be able to just scroll through all the open field of comments. So this is a pretty efficient way to deal with the verbatims, and it's also, you know, the place that you would want to go to start looking at trends, and you're still in that learning phase, you know, looking into trends and moving it forward so you can get to root cause analysis and start to take some action. So that's your dashboard comments screen. Okay, so when the dashboard gets turned on in April, the monthly summary report should be populated. And what it is, it's a good report to print out. It has each one of the segment audiences isolated. It gives the council NPS for that audience, the area NPS, and the national NPS. So again, you can go ahead and compare where you're performing in accordance to that comparison right there. By clicking on the detractor, passive, or promoters, you'll get more insight into how each group has scored in each one of the questions. So you can go ahead and expand those out and print the whole thing for your staff meeting, for your committee meetings, for your board meetings, and you can, you know, expand them all out, you know, collapse them if you need to, and the print functionality on the dashboard will be able to get you what you're looking at right in your hands, so you don't have to rely on the computer to talk about VLS all the time. So this is a good report for actually making VLS a part of the way that you do business and consider your decisions at every single time you're sitting down with your team or with your stakeholders to make sure that you're making decisions based on member experience and improving that. Okay, thank you. We can go ahead and go to the next screen. Okay, so we have the resources page, and if you've been on any of our webinars, you know that it's scouting.org/JTE. And that is where the holy grail of everything we've been producing is there. We've got at the bottom left-hand corner of this web page, you'll see Voice of the Scout. It looks exactly like the box that you see here on the screen. We just posted some video shorts. They're 3 to 5 minute helpful insight types of videos. Specific to DSA, there's been some produced by the folks in Irving over at Media Studios. And we also have links to YouTube video shorts that are more general NPS topics. They're not branded Boy Scouts of America. That's why we went ahead and left them on YouTube. So we went ahead and created a few there that are just more generic for you to take a look at. The general, you know, information about NPS, leadership in NPS, the importance of making the customer connection. And then with the Voice of the Scout videos, it's the experience recovery, you know, the importance of that and some things to consider there. The importance of VLS for units. So if you just want someone at the unit level to get an awareness about that, this program, so they can help start promoting it in a way that is informed. If they can't sit down for an hour and listen to a recorded webinar, you can always send them this 3 to 5 minute video. So it's a good little quick overview. We've also put together a script to assist staff that have to make the experience recovery calls, and it's very logical. And it goes through every scenario. It's sort of like an if-then type of layout. It's only a couple pages, but I think that you'll find it helpful to be able to help train anyone that is making those experience recovery calls. And remember, whoever's making the experience recovery calls needs to be someone that's knowledgeable about not only about scouting, but also about the council. We want to make sure that whoever interacts with the members is someone that is going to further their confidence and not leave them more frustrated because the call ends with more questions than answers. So make sure you have the right people, you know, reaching out for these experience recovery calls. And this sample script should help anyone that you assign. And we also put up some new web banners. We had some really skinny long ones that are the popular size, but we also put some that will fit the SiteCore template. So we'll go ahead and give you some notification, and hopefully, you know, within the next day or two, just a quick day notice that we're going to go ahead and launch surveys, and that will be your cue if you are doing any web promotion to get on there. We've got a banner. It's ready, and you can put it on your website letting your members know that we are indeed surveying. So that's your resources page. Okay, so jteatscouting.org, you'll be able to get into contact with, you know, the gal on the webinar today, Patty Bowman, and some other people that work in the Mission Impact Department. They're incredibly helpful. They're very prompt. So by emailing that with any questions, they'll help you out. Also, if you'd like, you know, someone other than your Scout executive to be put on a VIP contact list, so we can email you information about VLS directly, go ahead and let us know who that is, what their email is, and we'll add them to that list. The National Service Desk, that these people are your contact for any technical questions associated with the dashboard, the JavaScript thing, or any type of inability to view. That's where your expertise is by calling your National Service Desk. And then, of course, all those resources at scouting.org/JTE. We really want people to go there because there's just a plethora of stuff out there. So everything from all these webinars are getting recorded, the PowerPoints are getting posted. We've got a deck there that's like a 5-minute introductory type of thing for your boards if you haven't introduced VLS to your boards. So be sure to check out that page because I think that you'll find that you won't have to recreate the wheel on promoting or educating everyone in your council about VOS. I think we've covered it, and so please do visit that site. Okay. All right, so this is where we usually open it up to questions. So under the box on Safari browsers, it's the lower right-hand corner. If you have questions, go ahead and type them in. And meanwhile, while people think about questions, Mike, is there anything else that you think needs to be added?
No, I don't think so, Candy. We're certainly very interested in having questions from our listeners. If there are any questions, things that we could help you understand better at this point in time. Anybody have a question, just type it in that to Mike Watkins' box there, and or to all, doesn't matter. And we're very happy to answer those online. We're very excited about the Voice of the Scout program. We're very excited about the kind of information that will be available to us both nationally and to you locally. And appreciate your council's interest in listening and caring and being willing to make changes in the way that we do business. And certainly we'll be looking at the ways that we do business to see just exactly how we can grow the membership. by providing scouts with a better experience.
Right, and you know what's really good about it with the metric itself being the only metric that truly represents the customer experience, and when you're seeing it on the JTE dashboard, it's we're offering this as a portal to really make it less than something that you're simply being graded on, as something that this is an operational tool. We're offering a system up with Voice of the Scout to be able to, for every council, based on their experience, based on their members, based on their environment, capturing it in a way that is relevant for councils. And I think that that's important to everyone on the call.
So we do have a question, and the surveys will be launching this week, today, and through the rest of the week. The survey will be open for a week, and then folks that have not responded will get a reminder. They'll have another week to answer. And so basically by the end of March, first or second day of April, the survey will then close for the spring cycle. And then that data that we've received from your respondents is what will populate into the Voice of the Scout dashboard. You'll be able to see that on April 9th. So again, remember, the surveys go out. If there are people who want to be contacted, that information will be populating right away. So if the survey goes out and somebody answers it in the next hour, if they want to be contacted, then that experience recovery report that's in your council, that will go, you know, if you have that turned on, you'll be able to see that immediately. So it is important to make sure that you get that experience tracker report turned on. There might be, say, a homepage for someone in the council to be able to respond if there are those kind of contacts that need to be made. All right, well, again, thanks, everybody, for being online with us today. There are no other questions. We appreciate your time this morning. Have a great rest of the day.